Okay, guys, since Martin Luther King's birthday is tomorrow, January 15th, and we're going to be celebrating that day and having that day off from school, we're going to do some supplemental homeschool lessons on Martin Luther King. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read from the biography that we got yesterday from the library, and there are some key questions that I want you guys to get the answers to.
Wait, tomorrow how old is he going to be?
Well, he isn't alive anymore, so I don't know how old he would be tomorrow, but we can look that up after we finish. He's going to be
67?
No, not if he's born in the 1929. He might be old. He's going to be older than that. But we'll calculate that. Just give me a second. Cameron, stop.
The boys came. He's going
to
be 99
because
he's old.
We'll calculate it when we do our math lesson. So the first question that I want you to answer is, when was Martin Luther King Jr. born? The second question is, who was he married to? The third question is, what did Martin Luther King lead in Montgomery, Alabama? What did he organize in Washington, D.C.? And what was the name of his famous speech? So Mason, you take the pad, and then while I read, as you hear the answers to those questions, you guys are going to write down the answers. So that'll help you guys learn how to do research for research projects and different things like that. Just like what you're doing for your Muhammad Ali project at school, Mason.
Because I don't know how to spell it anyway.
Well, I'm going to read it, and then you can write it down. And if you spell it wrong, we can fix the spelling in just a second. Okay, so I'm going to start reading. Martin Luther King Jr. was born on January 15th, 1929, in Atlanta, Georgia. He had a younger brother and an older sister. Martin Luther King Jr. always did very well in school and even skipped two grades in high school. So from what I just read, was there anything that answered one of those questions in there?
Yes.
What question was answered?
When was he born?
Okay, does anybody remember what it said for when he was born?
Yes.
Chico? January what?
January the 19th.
No, the 15th. 1929. So you got the month, so that's really good. You're on your way to being a researcher. Okay, so he went to college at the age of 15 and eventually became a preacher like his father. He married Coretta Scott King in 1953 and had four children. Martin Luther King Jr. was assassinated in Memphis, Tennessee in 1968. So, was any of those questions? You sure? Let's reread the questions again and let's see if any of those are in there. When was he born? We got that. Who was he married to? Did we get that question? I think that was answered in this paragraph.
Can you read it again?
Mm-hmm. He married Coretta Scott King in 1953 and had four children. So who did he marry? Mason, you gotta let him answer it. Coretta Scott King. Okay. Mm-hmm. We can, when we go through the sheets, I'll show you how to spell it. Coretta. Scott King.
Scott King.
Mhm. Okay, so we're gonna go on to the next page. Martin Luther King Jr. experienced racism at an early age. He knew it was not fair to treat people differently because of the color of their skin. He wanted to do something to make a difference. Martin Luther King Jr. became active in the civil rights movement. He led the bus boycott in Montgomery, Alabama. He always wanted to lead peaceful protests to fight for equality. Are any of those statements in any of our questions that we needed to research?
No.
You sure?
Yeah.
Let's read. What did Martin Luther King lead in Montgomery, Alabama?
The bus boycott
is when African American people chose to not ride the buses anymore because they were not allowed to sit in the front of the bus. So they decided that they would not take the buses anymore to show that their money was important and that they were valued as citizens, because if they didn't ride the bus, that they weren't the bus company wasn't getting their money to pay for them to ride the bus anymore.
Where does he live at?
He lived in Montgomery, Alabama.
And his house is a museum now.
Oh, we gotta look that up. I didn't know that.
He has a new day.
I watched it on a movie. His house is a museum.
Oh, we gotta check that out. Check that movie out.
He has a museum.
It's a museum?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, guys. So we're gonna go on to the next one.
Wait, what was it? The
bus boycott. And a boycott is just basically choosing not to use or do something as a group. So if we all decided we're not gonna shop at Food Lion anymore, or we're gonna boycott Food Lion, we're not gonna shop there anymore, or something like that.
Or like we're never gonna go.
There's all the grocery store.
What if
we're gonna eat food? We have to grow our own food
then
and make it.
No.
I know what you're talking about, Mommy.
Okay, so the next question is...
We're never going to get no food or shop.
Right.
Mason!
So the next question is... we're going to continue reading. He always wanted to lead peaceful protests to fight for equality. Martin Luther King Jr. organized the March on Washington in Washington, D.C. Where he gave his famous I Have a Dream speech to over 200,000 people. He won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1964.
He had a green speech.
I know what you're talking about.
He had a what?
He had a green speech.
Yep, that's the famous. That's the famous speech. Good job. And then there was one more question in there.
Did he have a lot of friends in high school?
It doesn't say that.
Yeah, he did.
But
I'm sure he did.
Does it say that?
No.
It just said he did very well in high school. And he skipped 2 grades. That means he was very smart.
He skipped 2nd grade, 4th grade.
I'm not sure. It doesn't say. Well, in high school, that's not That's not it. It must be he didn't have to go to 11th and 12th grade. He just went to college when he was in 10th grade.
You know what?
Because he was very smart.
Mm-mm.
Why?
Because he made an experience.
Amazing. Okay, we'll look that up to see exactly why he skipped. Okay, so let's see. What did he organize in Washington, D.C.? It was
2000.
No, he organized the March on Washington. And that's where he gave his famous speech. I have a dream.
It's like taking a shower or something. Wait, do he have a TV in his house?
No, he's not alive. He's not alive anymore. When they said that he was assassinated means somebody shot him.
The boy has a TV.
Mm-hmm.
No, mommy, it's not assassinated, it's eliminated.
No, it was assassinated.
It's
mommy, this boy has a TV. Is he at the hospital?
No. He died.
He's in the ground. No, if he's not in the ground, he's up there with God having fun.
But he died.
He's dead.
Mm-mm. He's a ghost now.
He's not a ghost. Stop it, Mason. He's not a ghost.
Mm.
Don't say that. All right, so let's answer those questions. What did he organize in Washington, D.C.?
A green speech.
Nope, he organized the March on Washington.
Did you say that already?
That was his famous speech.
The what?
Huh?
The what?
When it's God Day?
What was the what?
What?
The Model Us.
It's God
the March
Day?
On Washington.
The March...
On Washington.
What is it?
On
a microphone. No, what's that?
That's his microphone. That's where he was giving his speech. I have his dream speech.
Oh. Well, here's that.
You know
that. But why is it right here?
Because he was standing in front of a podium.
Oh. So okay. He was telling everybody
So let's go through each question. So I'm gonna read them. I'm gonna read the question and you guys answer them. Okay. When was Martin Luther King Jr. born?
Mommy,
here's January 15.
Mommy?
What year? 19 what?
Mommy,
1929. Good job. Okay, who was he married to?
Mommy always had him in his...
It's Scott King.
Coretta Scott King.
Coretta Scott King.
Mm-hmm. What did he lead in Montgomery, Alabama?
The Bus Boy Scouts.
Boycott that Boy Scout. Chico, sit back.
Okay. In a bus over there.
Okay, and what did he organize in Washington, D.C.?
It's right up here, Chico. You don't have to say,
Well, you have to help him.
The Martian word. March on Washington, D.C.
What was the name of his famous speech?
The March on Washington.
Mm-mm. That's not the name of the speech.
What?
It's not.
The why.
I have a dream.
Oh.
I have a dream.
We'll listen to it after this video.
I just said it. I almost said it.
You can hear
it.
Okay.
All right. He had a bug dream. But I almost said it.
What do you guys remember what we discussed, what the word boycott means?
Mm-hmm. When he decided to get in front of the bus.
No. When he decided that...
Not to sit in a bus.
Not to get on the bus at all. Right. What about equality? Does anybody know what equality means?
It means...
You said what?
Mama
means
karate.
Not equity. Mama, equality.
Mama karate.
No, not karate. Equality.
About
karate?
No,
money.
I said money.
No, equality means... Well, it could mean money. It just means that everybody is
money.
Everybody's treated equally.
Mama cuckoo.
And what Martin Luther King was wanting for equality is that black people and white people were treated with equality.
He was a boxer.
Mommy.
And what about racism? Does anybody know what racism means?
Wait, hold on.
Like erasing something.
Mm-mm. Racism.
Racism?
No, Mason asked me what did I say. I said racism.
Racism?
Mm-hmm. You know what that means?
A judge?
No, racism means when somebody doesn't like somebody else because of their skin color.
Because they're white.
Or it could be somebody doesn't like somebody because they're black.
Or they're peach.
Right. And
or the type of black skin or dark skin.
Right. And civil rights. Does anybody know what civil rights means?
Yeah.
Means what does that mean, Mason?
Something's not fair.
Civil rights means something's not fair?
Yeah.
What do you mean? What does that mean?
It means
somebody had $1 million and somebody only had one.
It's not fair. It's like,
so that means that the wealth is not equally distributed?
Yes.
It's like two people. And the other person had $2, and the other person had $3, and the other person won the prize.
Mm-hmm. The African American people person, in this country.
The other person said, that's not fair.
Mm-hmm. African American people in this country were slaves, and when Martin Luther King came along, they were no longer physically slaves, but the laws that were put in place. Like Jim Crow laws and things like that, they still treated black people really badly. So he wanted to make sure that all people were treated the same.
I mean, I put this on the bottom.
What?
Because I love Martin Luther King Jr.
All right. So, all right, we're going to finish this lesson. Say bye to everybody on YouTube.
What?
We're finishing the lesson. Say bye-bye.
Now I'm my homework, mommy.
Mm-hmm. We did your homework. We just answered the question.
Bye.
So we're going to write them down and put it nice and neat in your folder. All right. Everybody say bye.
Bye.